Leveling up. Extreme business growth through raising your game. When what was once extraordinary becomes ordinary, you know you've leveled up.
Hello and welcome to the Leveling Up podcast with me, George Swift. The Leveling Up podcast is here to give you the personal development, the entrepreneurial development and the business growth that you, the ambitious business owner, desires. I'm here to give you the inspiration, the motivation, but as always, to challenge your aspirations to take you and your business to the next level. Don't forget, subscribe to this podcast so that you never miss an episode. Today, it is Friday, and we're going to have a Friday 5-Minute Fix. These are shorter podcast episodes designed to take into weekend, give you food for thought, to ponder upon, and to come out on Monday all guns blazing. Today, I want to round up this week's content by saying it might be time just to step back for a moment, to take a step back and to assess and to reassess, to look at where you're at in your business, look at how far you've come, look at where you're going, look at the problems you're facing. Look at what are short-term problems, look at what are longer-term chronic issues that you need to fix in your business, to maybe take some time out to do some strategizing, do some planning, do some goal setting. Gandhi once said, "Today I have twice as much to do, therefore I must meditate for twice as long." So I kind of bastardize that saying and crudely say, "Today I have twice as much to do, so I must plan for twice as long. Today I have twice as much to do, therefore I must plan twice as much." If you're facing at the moment real stress, if you're facing real pressures, if you've got a lot on your plate, like I know a lot of business owners have at the moment, I know, I get it. The temptation is to just keep pushing harder, fighting harder, driving harder. And you know, you're never going to find anyone that backs the concept, the notion of fighting harder for what you want than myself. But we also need to be strategical. We also need to be cognitive of our problems, of our solutions, of our options. We need to take time out to really think, to solve problems, and to make sure we're taking the right actions, not just for now, but also for our longer term prospects. This week, we looked at the concept of having the right tool for the right job. We talked about digging a ditch with a teaspoon. And if you never sit back and you never pull yourself away from the problem, if you never take yourself away from the coalface, then what happens is you lose sight of your opportunities. You lose sight of the options to make life easier for yourself. You lose sight of your priorities, what you should be doing, what you shouldn't be doing. You never find the time in order to reassess how you're approaching your business, to reassess the tools you're using in order to deliver your business. And therefore, you end up just panicking and just digging faster and faster with this teaspoon, this incredible ditch. If you haven't listened to episode 169, then go and listen to that over the weekend as well, especially if you're someone that feels like they're working really hard for not a lot of returns. On Wednesday, episode 170, we talked about the two types of people in a sinking boat. We talked about the one that was just panicking and just trying to bail water as fast as they can, but being completely oblivious to the fact that the water's still coming in and all they're doing is delaying the inevitable, the sinking of their vessel. We talked about the other person being the person that sat back and thought about, why are we letting on water? How do we solve that problem? Where is that problem? You know, we talked about the person that is short-term focused, just trying to do more, faster, harder. And then we talked about the person that sat back a little bit and was creative. And instead of doing more, faster, harder, they were asking the question about, what do I need to be doing differently? We can't do that when we're right up against the coalface, when we're bailing the water out of the sinking ship. We can't think clearly. We need to take time out in order to think clearly, to problem solve properly, to really assess what's going on. And for you right now, that might be what you need to be doing this weekend. You may have gone through hell over these past months. Many small business owners have gone through hell. They're still continuing to go through hell. And for many of us, the worst still yet might be to come. And before we go out there and just continually just keep smashing away at the cold face, before we just continually keep digging that massive ditch with our tiny little teaspoon, before we go out there and just continually just keep bailing water without any real thought about why we're letting on water in the first place, then we're just going to make life so hard for ourselves, and there's a real risk that you're not going to go the distance. I don't mean this in terms of your business. I mean this in terms of yourself. There's a real risk you might burn out. I work with, 80 plus small business owners from almost startup all the way through to multiple millions of pounds. And, you know, I can see the weariness, the tiredness. I can see how the toll of the last few months has really worn them out. For some of them, they are close to burnout. And for some of them, you know, they're there and they're hammering away and they're hammering away. And, you know, we're needing to say, look, you know what? Just step back, take a breather, relax for a moment, take care of yourself, nurture yourself. Take the space that you need, the time that you need in order to regroup, in order to refresh yourself so that you can go in there and then you can start tackling the next battle, the next challenge. Because fundamentally, success is a long game. And therefore, we need to go the distance. And if we don't go the distance, we don't survive the distance, then we're never going to win. At the moment, of course, there are some terrible things that we're facing in business. There's terrible things in life that we're facing. There's the decisions that are being made for us on our behalf on what we can do and what we can't do as businesses. For many of us, we've got our legs tied together and one arm behind our back at the moment. And because of that, of course, it makes everything harder, tougher. And we have to tackle these problems. We have to reinvent ourselves potentially. We have to re-engineer aspects of our business. You know, we have to make sure that we've got what we need in place in order to be able to surf whatever wave, tsunami of shit that is in store for us as business owners. So you know what? This weekend, maybe you do need to get down onto the cold face. Maybe you do need to bail some water. Maybe you do need to have your nose pressed up against it. You need to fight harder. Maybe you need to have a quieter one. Maybe you need to have a more purposeful one. Maybe you need to have a more thoughtful one. And maybe you have to look at your plans, your strategies, your tactics, start looking at your problems and your issues and start thinking and preparing for that long game. Thank you for listening once again. I hope you've had a good week. Have a great weekend. Do whatever you need to do in your business, in your life to make sure that you make it count. I will see you on Monday. We'll do it all over again. I'll drop a link into the description for the six-figure fast track. This is how to take your business from 10, 20, 30, 40K, maybe even 50K if you've come that far. How to take your business to 100K or more in the next 12 months or less. Regardless of the economy, regardless of what other shit we're dealing with at the moment, you really can still continue to grow your business. The rules for the six-figure fast track, they haven't changed. How we apply them has, and more importantly, the importance has probably never been so great that we're doing the right things in our business for where we're at right now. Get yourself on the six-figure fast track. You'll find that at biggerbrighterbolder.co.uk/fast track. I'll drop that in the descriptions as well as some resources that you can also have access to. Maybe this weekend you need to do some strategical thinking, maybe go and consume the six-figure fast track, see how it relates and how it applies to your business so that you can take yourself and your business to the next level. Have an awesome one. I'll see you on Monday. Until then, as always, be successful.
Leveling up. Extreme business growth through raising your game. When what was once extraordinary becomes ordinary, you know you've leveled up.